you made it through. Okay, you also deserve a round of applause. All right, so we are very much aware of the impact of COVID-19 to us, specifically on sport, no? The physical activity and social well-being. Our social well-being is greatly affected. Our children are particularly affected by social and physical distancing. And, you know, considering sport is commonly used as a tool to foster cooperation and sportsmanship and promote respectful competition. You know, without sport, many young people like you are losing the support system that such participation provided. So schools have begun using virtual training as a method for leagues, coaches, and children to remain engaged in sports activities while remaining in their home. So isn't it that exercising at home, bending here and there without any equipment and limited space is still possible? Is it a yes? Yes, this pandemic did not stop us from helping our students develop their skills and hone their talents. Our students under the GIFT sports courses can still stay fit even at home. And you know, the COVID-19 pandemic has had and will continue to have very considerable effects on the sporting world, as well as on our physical and mental social well-being. But then again, in SPCP, we will continue to offer you the benefits that sport and physical activity can bring even in the age of COVID-19. So once again, thank you, dear coaches, dear parents, and our students. Thank you very much. Continue to love this sport. Continue to love gymnastics. Have a blessed day. Keep safe. And God bless us all. Caritas Christi Urget Nos.
Thank you for those encouraging words, Mrs. Patingo. As we've mentioned at the start of the program, this virtual gym fest is a product of the hard work and flexibility of our coaches and fellow students who continue learning gymnastics at home. Let's take a look at some of the things that they do at home.
Say they're investigating a viral pneumonia outbreak and there's speculation that it could be linked to a SARS virus that killed hundreds of people in 2003.
A mysterious pneumonia has gripped China with scores hospitalized by the illness.
Tablet or laptop.
We hope that video has given you a better idea on how gymnastics can be taught and learned online. And now it's time for us to feel our virtual Gym Fest vibe. Are you guys ready for the exciting part of this festivity? Let us hear all your cheers for our grade school varsity team with Let's Get It Started.
Thank you.
Grabe, wow, that was one energetic performance talaga from our very own grade school varsity team. Don't you agree, Lian?
Oo nga, you wouldn't see the difficulty of creating it online. Thank you, grade school varsity team. You've set the bar for this morning's Gym Fest. Now, this is just a teaser on what's to come. So stay tuned and stay with us until the end. Trust us, you wouldn't want to miss it.
Just as we don't want to miss out on hearing the personal experiences of our fellow students who learn gymnastics online, I mean, seryoso ba? How can you learn it without your coaches by your side, no? What's it like doing gymnastics at home? So let's hear from some of our gymnasts.
Doing online gymnastics training is a new and fun way of learning gymnastics at home. It made me fit and strong by doing warm-ups and gymnastics skills. Some of the benefits that I had was I get to exercise and work out at home that kept me stay healthy and strong.
In my opinion, slightly more difficult to handle or do than face-to-face training. Since, based on my experiences, there were times when I wasn't able to properly perform the skill or conditioning we were told to do, either because I lacked some equipment needed, or my area was just too small to actually do it. But I'm still able to do my conditioning and perform my skills. Even at home, thanks to the coach's training, our body still remains fit and strong, prepared to do whatever skills we are told to do easily. It may be a little more laxed than face-to-face training, since we have to take note that we are at our homes and our coaches are not physically with us, but it serves its purpose to keep our body conditioned, fit, and strong so that we can still do our skills like before.
At first, I found it challenging to do online gymnastics at home because I can't really have assistance with my form or skills from my coach personally, but later on, I was able to rely on myself more and I started encouraging myself to become more independent when it comes to learning new skills or enhancing and polishing routines and my form. But even if I was doing gymnastics only at home, it provided me the physical activity I needed to keep fit and strong. And I also like that I still get to train even at the comfort of home, and I have more time to do my other tasks because I don't have to travel to go to training.
It's fun doing gym at home because I can stay near my dogs and still be fit while I'm at work. And I don't like the fitness strong because I can already do this hard skill that I never did before, which is that. And it gave me the courage to do that dance, but I'm not really good. I can't do it yet, but I'm still practicing, and it made me stay away from all of my.
Doing gymnastics virtually at home is super different from the usual practices that we have. It's nakakapanibago because we don't have our apparatus. And second is that our coaches are just virtually with us to help us do our conditionings and skills, and not like before that they would help us to do our skills. But I do think that online training made me physically fit and healthy because our conditionings just get harder and harder each time, every training. And doing those conditionings just feel like my body gets more fit every time I need to move. And having training every other day just makes me stronger. And yeah, I do feel like that online training made me stronger because on the usual training day before, we would usually do more skills than conditionings, but now in online we would focus more on our conditionings and exercises for our form. So for me as a gymnast, I do think that training online is an effective way for me to still be a good athlete.
I guess in summary, their love for the sport is their greatest motivator. Discipline, trust, and courage are their fruits of labor. the discipline to work on their routines and forms on their own time, the trust that they can do the stunt on their own, and the courage of actually doing the stunt or skill without a coach physically by their side. That being said, let us welcome on screen a special solo performance from Autumn Cordova.
Since we break down first at the nightlight, shoes on, getting a walk up a mill, let's rock and roll. Kick out, kick the drum, running on like a rolling stone. Sing song when I'm walking home, jump up to the top of the throne. Ding dong, call me on my phone, nice to see how I get my ping pong.
Ang galing. That was a breathtaking performance from our very own Autumn. Thank you for sharing your talent and inspiring us more. Now, let us welcome our very own high school gymnastics varsity.
Well, this car is automatic. It's systematic. It's hydromatic. Why, it's a greased lightning.
We'll get some purple French tail and a stretchy French tail, oh yeah. A Palomino dashboard and doom of the twins, oh yeah. With new pistols, guns, and shots, I can get all my rocks. You know that I ain't bragging, she's a real pussy wagon. Greased lightning. You're going through this life and you're burning up the corner of my.
Greased lightning, go, greased lightning.
Go, greased lightning, you're burning up the corner.
You can try to stop the seasons, girl, but you know you never will. And you can try to stop the
feeling, feel the hair, naman ng background ko. Isang para sa nasa resort.
Thank you.
Wow, our high school varsity proves that gymnastics is possible in our own homes. You wouldn't even see that they haven't been training physically together in the gym. Di halata nga. Oh. Next up is a performance by our member of the high school varsity team. She will do a routine on the balance beam. Let's welcome Doreen Astorga. Ang galing! Very impressive! Bet you didn't think that we could also do beam routines at home? Well, of course, our younger sisters wouldn't back down from this. Let's all cheer for the grade school gymnastics gift team. Grabe, what a performance from our grade school gymnastics gift team. Napakagaling talaga. I bet everyone is enjoying today's virtual Gym Fest Total Body Reset with these powerful performances. Diba, Lian?
I agree, Ate Paula. I'm so glad that you're here to witness these performances. Now, let us put the spotlight on our next guest. This year's high school gymnastics varsity captain, Josephine Danielle Javier.
Josie Javier. I'm an outgoing senior and the current team captain of the high school varsity team. And I've been doing gymnastics for mga roughly 13 years. I've been doing gymnastics since I was 6 years old, and I remember the first time that I touched the mats, I went in the gym and did my first cartwheel. And I remember just loving the thrill and loving it. And I don't know, ever since then, I love the sport. Until now, I say I love the sport. Doing and being a gymnast at such a young age, I think it really played a big role in my character development. Like, at the age of 6 years old, I was taught how to have confidence in myself, how to be fearless, and how to take risks. As a young kid, I was super, super duper makulit. But through the coaches and through my training, I was taught discipline and the idea of when to have fun and when to be serious. Gymnastics taught me, like, a lot. It taught me discipline, hard work, confidence, perseverance. But I think the most prominent thing that it taught me is the ability to push myself past my limits. Like, gymnastics taught me that I'm so much stronger than I think I am and that I'm capable of so much more as long as I have the heart, the faith, and the determination. Like, I remember there were training days talaga na, not gonna lie, umiiyak na ako kasi kala ko di ko na kaya. But because my coaches and my teammates pushed me on and motivated me and gave words of encouragement. To my surprise, kinaya ko naman yung mga trainings, nagawa ko yung mga difficult skills na tinatakutan ko. And I guess I carry that with me till this day, especially ngayon na online setup. Kasi puro stress. And, you know, we question kung hanggang saan ko pa talaga kaya to. Pero I just go back to the stress and the pagod I felt in gym and remember na just like how I overcame that before, I can overcome this because, yun nga, I'm tougher and so much stronger than I think. Gymnastics honestly opened so many doors and gave me so many opportunities, like traveling and competing abroad, performing at shows, and even led me to try out to be part of the Team Philippines cheerleading and be part of some commercials. Like, I can honestly say now, without gym, I would never have the chance to do any of those. But above all the opportunities it gave me, the thing that I'm most grateful to gymnastics is that it gave me a lifelong family and a place to always call home. And of course, other than gaining a new set of sisters, I really feel that I was able to gain a new set of parents slash titas and titos slash friends na din. And I'm talking about no one other than the coaches. The coaches talaga gave me the support and the love that I never knew was capable from anyone other than my family. Like, through all my ups and downs, they were there for me not only as coaches, but as my family and my friends. Like, they taught me so many things about gymnastics, but more importantly, they taught me so many things about life. Life lessons that have helped me overcome the toughest challenges, and I'm sure will be very useful and important in the challenges I face in the future. So for the people interested in gym, I'd say just go for it. Like, shoot your shot. There's no harm talaga in trying it kasi what do you have to lose? Di ko naman pina-pressure, but at least, you know, if you want it, try. Kasi you never know what will happen, and even if it's not the right fit, at least you'll gain a new experience and a great story. For the people naman who I will leave behind, my fellow teammates, I know the situation is hard right now and that it's so hard to constantly show up and stay motivated. Kasi nga, we're all at home, and to be honest, Zoom gym doesn't feel the same. But I feel din na it's not fair for us to compare face-to-face gym with Zoom gym. Kasi totoo naman, limited yung mga equipment natin dito. We're only limited to a few set of skills because of safety reasons. But yun nga, it's the situation we have. We can't do anything about it. So we just have to remember that the coaches and the entire team is trying to do their best to pursue yung passion nga natin, yung passion natin for gym and the sport that we love. Also, remember na lahat ng conditioning na ginagawa natin, all the trainings, will all be worth it. Like, you might not see it now, but the little improvements will add up in the end and will manifest during the time that you touch the mats again and do your first round off, your first backhand, your first tumbling pass. And also, please, 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 I hope na even though aalis na kaming seniors, even though naalis na kami, I hope na the gym team will still continue to be a team and continue to be tight and unified. Like, I know it's hard right now kasi online and we're all separated. But I know na gym peeps are tight. So I really hope na you keep that bond and strengthen it pa and build yourself a family and a place to call home then. Kasi, honestly, yun yung pinaka blessing from gym na I got na I'm so grateful for. And I know that if you do it, you gain a family there, you'll feel the same love and fulfillment na I do. So yun, that's all I have to say for now. I hope na when all of this is over, I get to go to the gym again and see you guys. So for now, goodbye and good luck to the future gym team. Stay strong. Kaya to guys. Push through lang. Matitibay yung mga gymnasts. Bye-bye. Hope to see you soon.
Thank you, Ate Josie, for that wonderful performance. And thank you for joining us here for our virtual gym fest. Your presence has added to our fun and energetic morning. Your talk has also inspired us to do well in gymnastics.
Is everyone still with us? Ayan, let's keep the ball rolling, shall we? Up next, please all welcome back on screen the grade school varsity group for another routine that they recorded for us.
Thank you. Used to keep it cool, used to be a fool, all about the bounce in my step. Watch it on the news, what you gonna do? I could hit refresh and forget. Used to keep it cool. Should I keep it light, stay out of the fight? No one's gonna listen to me. If I write a song, preaching what is wrong, will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it light? Is that right? Way up, we go. Been up and down that road. Way up, alone. We gon' burn the whole house down. Watch me standing in line. You're only serving lies. You got something to hide. We gon' burn the whole house down. Let it go, walk into the show, gawking at the tricks of your sleeve. Too good to be truthful, I'm in a room full of entertainers and thieves. Used to let it go. Every stranger from Twitter to get shit done. Used to hang my head low, now I hear it loud. Every stranger from Twitter is gonna burn this down. Way up we go. Been up and down that road. Way up, oh no. We gon' burn the whole house down. Watch me standing in line.
OMG, ang galing nyo, guys! Keep it up, grade school varsity group! On to our next performer, we are fortunate to have another live solo performance. A member of the grade school varsity team, please welcome Chelsea Ann Ang.
Grabe, that was such an awesome performance, Chelsea. Thank you for letting us witness such a routine. Now, we are near the end of the program. I hope everyone is still with us. I hope also that everyone's enjoying the virtual Gym Fest Total Body Reset event with us.
Yes, I'm sure everyone is naman, Ate Paula. The performances this morning have pumped our energy to the ninth level. Let's sustain this energy with a live performance from the grade school varsity team.
Used to keep it cool, used to be a fool, all about the bounce in my step. Watch it on the news, what you gonna do? I could hit refresh and forget. Used to keep it cool. Should I keep it light, stay out of the fight? No one's gonna listen to me. If I write a song, preaching what is wrong, will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it light? Is that right? To the show, gawking at the tricks of your sleeve. Too good to be truthful. I'm in a room full of entertainers and thieves. Used to let it go. We
kudos to the grade school varsity team. You've prepared so many inspiring, breathtaking, and jaw-dropping performances this morning. And to give us a broader perspective on the benefits of gymnastics, here are the ladies who walk the same hallways in St. Paul Pasig. Let us all give a loud and proud cheer for our gymnastics alumni.
Hi, I'm Kaylan Rasin.
My name is Cristana Sanchon.
I'm Zoe Nabelman.
Hi, I'm Jeanette.
My name is Marian De Castro.
Hi, I'm Nina Pangan.
Hello, my name is Sofia Del Reyes.
My name is Zoe Valix.
My name is Christelle.
Hi, I'm Havana and I'm 22 years old. And I did gym for 13 years.
I did gymnastics for 11 years.
More or less 14 years.
Then for 11 years.
For 8 years.
11 years.
5 years.
13 years.
So I did gymnastics for about 8 to 9 years, I believe. And that shows really how important and how big of an impact it had into my life. So even if it was a somewhat overwhelming sport at times, it has really shaped me to become the person I am today. It has impacted me as I learned how to be more disciplined and overall just improve my self-confidence. And not only that, it has helped me with my time management skills, as I am a person who tends to procrastinate a lot. Gymnastics really helped me learn how to balance my schoolwork, extracurriculars, and even still find the time to rest. So that is really important because as we grow older, we get more responsibilities that we have to focus on.
So gymnastics opened up a whole new door for me, like not only in terms of like learning how to push myself physically, like kung saan yung extent na yon, pero I've also found like a second family in gymnastics kasi you're like training all the time with these people, and even though like personality wise in gym like we clash, pero parang we found a way to bond rin with our shared experiences, and you get to learn things not only from your teammates but from your coaches rin, like to build that mental fortitude na you can apply in gym and outside.
So before, I wasn't really that confident about myself, and I always doubted myself at often times. Even when I was a kid, I really wasn't that proud of myself, or I really didn't get to like find other platforms to boost my confidence. But here comes gymnastics, who comes into my life and helps me every day. So from there, I've boosted my confidence. That has helped me not only in gymnastics but also in school and in other activities that I am involved in, like organizations that I'm in. I joined different production teams also. Yeah, and that's all because of gymnastics and the boost and confidence that it has given me. So yeah.
So next is something you learned from gymnastics that you carry with you to this day. I think it would be having courage, like believing in oneself. Kasi I even remember like before doing a skill, sinasabi ko sa mind ko or like out loud, don't hesitate, just believe, ganon. Kasi I would overthink stuff like, paano kung ito yung nangyari, paano pag hindi ko nagawa, ganon. Pero paano mo malalaman if hindi mo matatry, so yun. There's really no harm in trying new things. Kasi ikaw lang rin naman makakaalam kung ano yung kaya mo. So it's best to just do it and trust yourself.
So coach always tells us before that your biggest competitor would always be yourself, and that still applies in any aspect of your life. In gymnastics, you're not only just flipping on the outside, but you're also doing mental gymnastics in your head, debating whether or not you can land the skill, do the jump, miss your mark, etc. So you learn how to trust and believe in yourself more, and with all those mental blocks when doing skills, you learn to persevere. And once you accomplish these things, it builds your confidence and you learn to be more self-aware and self-disciplined in a sense.
Actually, I learned from gym na when you put your heart into something talaga, ma-achieve mo yung gusto mo. Ma-achieve mo yung kung ano man yung goal mo. Yun yung natutunan ko hanggang ngayon. ginagawa ko pa din na parang binibigay ko talaga lahat ko para ma-achieve ko ano yung gusto kong gawin.
So, through gymnastics, I learned not to be afraid of trying new things. Because whenever we try a new skill, like, the only way that you can learn it is if you try it nga. So, how are you gonna be able to do this skill if you're afraid of trying new things? So, it helped me, like, to always push myself to go out of my comfort zone and not to be scared of failure. Because it's part of the process then. So, gymnastics helped me understand that failure is also part of the process.
Something I learned that I still carry on is that you always have to trust the process, because you don't see the result right away. You have to trust the process na talaga. So when I study, kahit mahirap, I do it because I know the exam is going to benefit me anyway. So it's similar with gym. I know trainings are hard, the workouts, but you'll see the result once you work hard for it.
So again, ayun nga, you try your best in order to achieve something. I still carry that with me until today, since ang daming pong nangyari ng college and getting something, I always do my best. I make sure na I try and make sure na I'll do anything in order to achieve it. Give my whole heart, give my whole passion for it in order to achieve it.
Probably for me is taking risks. I have this thing where just because I was a gymnast, I love doing things that are like worth questioning if I could actually do it. Just because I did gym, like I used to be able to do almost anything, like parkour, you know, carrying my own weight, and I just felt so confident. Or like, you know, confidence is basically one reason I carry with until this day. Like I believe in myself. Because I used to do so much before that I didn't think I would actually be able to.
So definitely discipline. Kasi like sa gym ko nalaman kung hanggang saan lang talaga yung motivation. Kasi at some point, wala kang motivation talaga to do something. And that's not wrong naman. Pero what's important is you have the discipline na even if you don't feel like it, but you know you should do it, like you have to do it. You have to take responsibility, and that's where the discipline comes in. And I carry it with me to this day because like in everything that I do, I don't like fully 100% naman like enjoy it all the time, pero you have to learn to take responsibility for things, and that's something I've learned.
So I know naman na gymnastics is a very challenging and demanding sport. But to be honest, like it will give you so many unique experiences and you're going to be able to learn so much from it. Like not just skill-wise or like not just in terms of gymnastics, but also like life lessons. And you'll be able to like carry those lessons with you all throughout your life. And then for those who are still in gym, I would just like say na have fun and enjoy yung training ninyo. And then makinig kayo kay coach. And then, yeah, just like enjoy the time that you have in gymnastics while you're still in high school right now. And just appreciate like everything that the coaches are doing for you. And I know it's like different now because it's not face-to-face. So it's like online training, ganon. Pero, I don't know, try to still find enjoyment in your training. And malay nyo, you guys can still like learn new skills kahit nasa bahay kayo, diba? Tapos pagbalik ninyo, wow, galing na niya. I don't know. Marian lang. Good luck to you guys.
So, the decade I've spent in gym with all my coaches and teammates will always be very special to me. You'll meet people you'll know forever and you'll learn so many things from them, whether it's on or off the mat. And you always have an amazing support system with you. You know, I got to travel a lot with my friends, which was super, super fun and my favorite thing in the world. And we went to so many Christmas dinners, graduation parties, movies, and so much more. And you know, it's so funny because we always, always like stressing on the always fight like siblings, but you know, at the end of the day, we'll always be there for each other. And you know, I know it's hard right now because of the pandemic, but if you push through, I promise it will be the best part of your life. You know, being just home, can take this time to better yourself physically or mentally. And once it's all over and you finally step on the mats, you know, it will all be worth it. So yeah.
Sharing my experience, I've also had a lot of hard times where I wanted to quit, I wanted to stop, ayoko na mag-compete, several breakdowns, ganun. But I still kept going kasi I didn't want my efforts to go to waste. So yun, knowing our situation now, alam kong it's hard to stay motivated during these times kasi nasa bahay lang tayo, tapos mahirap gumalaw, mag-train. Lalo na pag routines, gano'n, tapos nakakatamad mag-workout. But know that when all of this is over, when we come back to face-to-face trainings, you will come out stronger and makikita mo yan sa improvement mo in doing skills, and it will also show in how you carry yourself as a gymnast, as an individual. Gym is fun, guys. I hope you stay and make your time worthwhile and hang in there. We're all in this together. And ayun, have courage. Don't hesitate, just believe. Bye, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much to our dear alumni. Personally, para sa akin, I'm very proud to call you our alumni, to be proud na lumaki kami with you, and you continuously inspire us to do better and work harder talaga.
And before we end our virtual Gym Fest, Total Body Reset, please stay tuned after the prayer as we have one last surprise performance from our faculty.
And to lead us in our closing prayer is another member of the grade school gymnastics team. We have Annika Kalaw.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Gracious Father, as we come to the end of our time together, we thank you for what has been accomplished today. Thank you for watching over. Thank you for keeping us healthy and safe during this coronavirus. Help us stay motivated during this time as we go through these troubling times. Remind us of your goodness. May your love and grace to guide us in everything that we do. Today and in the future. This we ask in the name of the Father, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Annika, for our closing prayer, and thank you everyone for joining us this morning for our virtual Gym Fest. We hope that you enjoyed and discovered a new interest or maybe love for sport gymnastics.
Your support and good vibes have made this virtual event a success. But before you hit those leave buttons, please stay tuned for our community dance.
Once again, I am Paula Kalingasan.
And I am Lian Ignacio, reminding everyone to stay at home and follow health protocols. Stay safe, everyone!
Thank you,
and we're signing off as your commentators.
May we request the sisters, teachers, GTLs, students, parents, and everyone watching with us today to stand and join us in our community dance. Take it away, Coach Jerome.
Clap, 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 clap
Thank you, girls. Thank you so much. Our dear students, our guests. Thank you so much for watching. We love you all. We love you all. Thank you so much. Thank you, coaches. Thank you, students. Thank you, parents, GTLs, Assistant Principal, Mrs. Patingo, Mrs. Fernandez. Thank you so much for watching us.
Thank you, Coach Jay. And
thank
congratulations.
You,
galing, galing.
Thank you for
very
your love
good.
And
This is such an awesome activity. You were very organized, well-planned, and you have involved almost everybody. Very good. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, Miss. Thank you for your love and support. Thank you for your beautiful message.
Congratulations.
Encouraging ko. Thank you. I hope you enjoy watching us. Thank you, girls. Thank you, parents. Thank you. Thank you. Stay safe, everyone. God bless us. We love you.
We're going to leave.
Yes, po. Thank you
for joining us and watching, girls.
Love you. Thank you for your support, for your love.
Thank you, girls.
Bye. Let's do this again and again yearly. Pero mas maganda kung face-to-face na tayo. Yeah, see you soon. Bye-bye. Love you.
Bye, girls.
See you again. Bye. Keep safe, everybody. Have a nice weekend.
Thank you, girls. Hi, Miss Jesus.
Thank you, Autumn. Thank you, Miss Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, po.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your love and support. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy it all. Buti na lang record. Pero kung nakaano ba yung post?
Thank you, Isha. Thank you po. Sophia Ripoll, thank you po. Thank you.
Thank you to all the parents. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Andy. Thank you, Smile.
Okay.
Thank you, Charlie. Thank you po.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yung coach, marami ba tayong high school? Nag-attend ba sila?
Mayroong mga nag-attend, coach. Diba, nakita ko. Sila Andy Del Rosario, sila Martina.